In 2011, I spent 4 days at budget hearings, and this year, 8 days. A colleague had commented that perhaps my time would be better spent in the district since I was a new member, and this would give my constituents a better chance to get to know me. I believe that my constituents would agree with me that the budget is one of the most important legislative events that occurs, and learning as much as possible about the budget is a very important aspect of my job. I believe my time is well spent understanding the budget details, and as they say, the devil is in the details. And these budget details affect the daily, if not hourly, lives of my constituents and all of the citizens of the Commonwealth. My 30-year career further informs me that budget development is about revenues and expenses and the priorities that are identified that drive those revenues and expenses. This budget provides support for the priorities of this administration. It is evident that effort has been put forth on the expense side. My constituents want to know why a similar effort was not put forth on the revenue side. One response I have after listening carefully and reviewing budget-related materials is that the priorities I have heard include short-term money savings at a potential greater cost in the mid and long term. These mid and long-term costs do not even take into consideration what I refer to as soft costs. And the soft costs are the havoc wreaked in constituents' lives as a result of less than our strategic decisions in terms of the budget. Lost time, increased frustration, lost productivity, increased stress, et cetera. During the course of the hearings, I have been impressed with some initiatives on behalf of a few of the cabinet-level secretaries who appear to be using private sector best practices for the betterment of their departments and ultimately for better citizen service. In my very brief 15 months in office, I have seen and shared with my constituents the inefficiencies that I've witnessed in government, sometimes on a daily basis. And speaking of best practices, I have learned over time that a good leader would use the best practice of engaging a diverse group of stakeholders when making strategic decisions and ultimately major changes. Generally, I don't find people are adverse to changes if they are part of the process and feel vested in the process. And I remain concerned that the process has not included diverse groups of stakeholders in a meaningful way. If this year's budget negotiations echo last year, then 45.5% or more of the citizens will be excluded from the dialogue because members of the minority party were excluded from the budget discussions. I want to go on the record today that this is untenable if it happens again this year. I speak about the budget in most of my town hall meetings, and to date I've had 9 of those town hall meetings and will continue to include the budget on my town hall agendas. Citizens need to understand how it works and how to participate. I was struck during the hearings that we have no mechanism to get public input for the budget. Appropriations hearings are indeed public events, however, the public cannot participate. I think the citizens should help to determine the nice-to-haves versus the must-haves. And I would submit to you that the ultimate answer to determining must or nice is subject to opinion, and my opinion counts on behalf of my constituents, and their opinion counts as far as I'm concerned. To remedy this, I will be holding at least one public hearing in the 194th for my constituents to provide testimony on the budget. It is, after all, their tax dollars. I want to thank you for this opportunity to testify this afternoon, and I have a few short minutes left, I think, on the clock, and just want to say that I'm here after having left the Health Committee meeting that's going on as we speak on Acts 22 expedited regs. And this Act 22 was part of the welfare code budget that we passed last year. And again, the lack of process, I can appreciate the need for change, and I have an appropriate appreciation. I'm fiscally very conservative and have an appropriate appreciation for spending dollars as effectively and efficiently as possible. But the process that was followed to promulgate these massive changes, it's allowed a 15-day comment period, and that's giving the department the benefit of the doubt that the comments were posted in the AM on the 24th and not in the evening, as I suspect. This is day 8, business day 8 of that period. The comment closes tomorrow. for massive changes, and the department is updating the health committee now. This is not a reasonable process, and it's a process that deserves criticism. So I will be returning to that, but I would strongly, strongly, strongly urge the committee to engage in the most appropriate process possible as it pertains to these budget negotiations that are ahead of us. It is not only important to me, it is important to the 60,000 people that I represent, and I suspect very important to all of the citizens of the Commonwealth. So with that being said, thank you.